Welcome back to SAP Manufactory. Today, we are diving into the concept of the propagation range and how it affects the selection of resources and products for which planning can be changed. Let's get started. We will cover a variety of subtopics to give you a comprehensive understanding. Here is what we will be talking about: definition and importance of propagation range, resource-related planning within the propagation range, product-related planning within the propagation range, impact of propagation range on order creation, configuration and default settings for propagation range. So let's dive in and explore each of these topics in detail. Let's talk about the definition and the significance of the propagation range. The propagation range is a crucial concept in resource and product planning. It allows you to specify which resources and products can be modified during the planning process. This encompasses several key actions. Firstly, within the propagation range, you can create new orders and make changes to the existing orders for specified products. This flexibility ensures that your production process remains dynamic and responsive to changing demands. Secondly, the propagation range allows you to adjust the capacity and planning parameters of your resources, whether it is increasing production capacity or tweaking specific planning setting. These changes help optimize resource utilization. Lastly, you can change the resource assignment within the propagation range. This means reallocating resources to different tasks to better align with your overall production strategy. The propagation range empowers you to make these adjustments either interactively or during the production planning run. This dual approach ensures that you have both real-time control and automated efficiency in your planning process. Let's talk about the significance of the propagation range in resource and product planning. The propagation range allows you to specify which resources and products can be modified during the planning process. Let's break it down. Resources. Resources within the propagation range are essential for resource-related planning, particularly for detailed scheduling functions and heuristics. You can only change the planning for resources in the propagation range. This means you can schedule, reschedule, or deallocate operations for these resources exclusively. Products. Similarly, products within the propagation range are crucial for product-related planning. Changes in planning can only be made for products within this range. This includes creating, modifying, or deleting recipes exclusively for these products. An important aspect to note is when you create an order for a product that is in the propagation range, but the order contains components not in the propagation range. In this case, the system will not create any orders for these components. This ensures that only the specified resources and products are impacted during the planning process. Now let's talk about configurations. If you have not specified a propagation range for the planning functions you are using, the system uses the propagation range you have entered in customizing under advanced planning, specifically under maintain global parameters and defaults. This default setting ensures that there is always a predefined range for your planning activities, streamlining the planning process. Let's see the propagation range assignment in the SAP system. For that, let me open the product view. Now I am in the product view. So here going to setting propagation range. You see here the propagation range is assigned with the standard value, that is SAP all. So how it is assigned? When you first time use the RRP3 transaction, so by the time you will get a pop-up. So in that, this standard propagation range will be assigned in your user profile. So this is from the product view perspective. Let's see on the PPDS planning board. So I'm in the standard overall profile. If you see here, profiles, more profile, you can find the propagation range. So whatever the propagation range you want to configure, you can configure, then assign it to the overall profile so that that particular propagation range will be called automatically. Now we will see how to configure this propagation range. Let me get into the configuration mode. Advanced planning, detailed scheduling, maintain propagation ranges. Here you can find all the configured propagation range. And if you be in the change mode, you will have a create option as well. So let's check what is configured here. There are two options. One is a resource selection and a product selection. First, let's check the resource selection. Here it says all the resource is assigned with this propagation range. But if you see in this, you will have this option. So based on the location or the particular resource, or the based on the planner or the resource category, you can have your selection. You can restrict the resource selection here. And coming to the product selection, the product number, if you make it all product number applicable, or even you can restrict with the location level. So this is how you can create a propagation range to restrict the planning based on your requirement. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more insights on production planning and detailed scheduling. See you in the next video.